Hi everyone, welcome to the Premsoft Technical YouTube channel. Today we are going to start with the next pattern, and this pattern is which you are able to see on the screen. So first of all, we'll just understand about this pattern. Suppose I will read one value from the user, and that value I will consider as n is equals to 3. If user gave me the 3 value, I want to print in the first row all the 3 star, second row first and last star, and last row 3 star. Nothing but if the n value is 3, first and last row will be the complete stars and middle will be the spaces. I will take another example. Suppose if I give the n value as 5, so here the first row will have the complete 5 star, second and subsequent will be only first and last star will be there, like this. One more star and here star, and last row will be again complete star. So if you want to design this pattern, how to do it in C language, that we will see. So first of all, I will just open the Turbo C program. I hope guys you have seen my last videos. If you are aware of the patterns, it will be very easy to understand this pattern. So I will just go to the file. I will take a new file to write the program. I will just clear all those extra stuff which is not required, and I will write the program. As you know, we need here I comma j comma n. I is nothing but number of row, j is nothing but number of column, n is nothing but how many rows you want. So first I will write clrscr to clear the screen. After that, I am asking the user how much row do you want to print. Like we have seen, n is equal to, so you can take any value. So as per the requirement you can give the value. So I am writing here enter the number. So let us say user has given the 3, so it will print the 3 pattern. If you give the 5, it will print the 5 pattern. So depends on your requirement, you pass the value. Now I am taking the for loop. I will explain each and every line in detail. I less than or equals to n, I am taking I plus plus. Then internal, I will take one more for loop. Those who are not aware of the complete for loop, I will just tell you, at least you must have the basic knowledge of for loop. If you know the basics, then I will take care of the rest of the things. First I will write the logic and then I will explain the one by one logic here. So I am taking here, see here, first what I am doing, I am writing I is equals to 1, I less than or equals to 3. Nothing but if I give the n value, it will execute 3 times this loop. Inside also I am writing I less than or equals to n. Nothing but if the n value is 3, it will execute 3 times. And sorry, I did the mistake here, you have to take j. Now what is the first concept we require, guys? First concept is nothing but first and last row should be completely star. I want to print on the screen. So the first row is nothing but what, I value should be 1 and the I value should be n, because first row is nothing but I value is 1 and last row is nothing but I value should be n. So inside this inner for loop, I will write the logic. If I equals to 1 or I equals to n, very carefully guys, and if this is true, I will just write if and else. But inside the else, I am not going to write any logic right now, and inside the print, I will just print the star, because first and last row I want to print the star logic. Okay, now just understand very carefully what I am telling here. If my I value is 1, nothing but row is 1, or I is equals to n, nothing but last. Sir, what is the meaning of OR operator? Either this condition to be true or this condition to be true. If one of the condition is true, we have to print the star. So what will happen, on the first and last row we'll get all the stars, and after completion of the row, we already are aware to go on the new line, that is slasher. Okay, control F9 will check the output first, whether it is working on fine or not. Okay, suppose I give the I value is 5. So see, first and last row we are getting perfectly fine, there is no problem. If I give the I value is 3, is it working fine? Absolutely fine, there is no problem. It means when the I value is 1 and the I value is n, we are getting first and last row star. And how many star we are getting? If j value is 1, 1 to n is nothing but n value is 5, so 5 star we are printing. Guys, those who are not aware of the loops, I will suggest you, I am having my loop series in this playlist, around 14 to 15 already I uploaded. You just go through that loop, you will get this topic very easily. Now, if that row is not first and last, obviously it will go to which part? Else part. In the else part, again I will write the if j is equals to 1 or j equals to n. What is the meaning of this? If the inside on the row, if the it is a first column, what is the meaning of column j? Already you are aware of this. If j value is 1 or j value is n, nothing but first, either first column or last column, you should print the star. So I am writing here star. If this is not the first and last row, what we have to do? We have to take one more else inside this one. So here what we have to print? Space. Because if it is not a first and last row, I want to add the space. Just listen very carefully, guys. If this is not the first and last row, it will come to which block? Else block. In the else block, I am writing one more if else. If it is a first column, nothing but j value is 1. Or if it is a j value is n, nothing but either it should be the first column or it should be the last column. If this condition is satisfied, it will print the star. If this condition is not first and last row, it will give the space. Let us see with the example. I am giving the value as compile, run the program and give the output as 5. Is it working fine? Absolutely correct. If you give the n value as 3, again it will come. I hope you understood here. Only thing you have to remember, you need the total 3 variable I, J and N. N is nothing but number of rows. I is nothing but N is nothing but how many times you want to repeat that code, nothing but n value. So whatever the value you will give, that many times this first for loop will repeat. This is nothing but number of rows and this is nothing but number of column. So I hope guys you understood here. If you are having any doubts, please comment me or reply me. Once more time I will show you the output. If you are want to check the output, you can write it down. Okay, so thank you for watching my video. If you are having any doubts, please comment me or just send me your doubts on my mail ID. My mail ID is this one. So thank you for watching this video, guys.